Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. We are heading back to Myersco College for another clinic with Pam. I'm hoping now that Bambi was there last week and she's got a feel for the arena and what it's like with riding with other horses, that we will have a really good session. And if we don't, that's fine, she's a baby, she's allowed. So I'm also hoping that you are enjoying me taking you out to lessons, so that you are hopefully picking up on some new tips, because I certainly have learned a lot from both my last two lessons, both one with Pam and one with Brian. And I'm going to continue to try and do as many of these a month now with both of them, because I just think it's really going to help me and Bambi A, strengthen both of our weaknesses, and also just bring us up to scratch of where we need to be, in the hope that we can get out to some dressage maybe at some point this year, and hopefully some clear rounds with Bambi. I'm not pushing it for competitions, but if we get there, we get there. So I'm just gonna hitch up, I'm gonna get sorted, and then I'm gonna get going. So come along and I hope you enjoy. Where are we? You like it here?
Well done. Okay, and then when you're ready, go forward to the trot. And the work initially on setting the rhythm in the trot. We want them forward but not back. So shoulders back, a little length of your range. Let your hands come back towards your body. Good, more forward. Good, Sarah. Don't you rise quicker than he drops then. Keep your body just a little bit taller. Don't let your shoulders drop forward to make the step bigger. Think about you staying in the middle of the horse, both of you. Just relax your inside hand there a little. Don't get into that discussion with contact, just rise above. Ignore the head. Big steps, both of you. Good, that. Allowing them to drop forwards, there's no backwards pressure with the hand. Okay. forward. Keep your hands still and relax, there we go. That's it. So now once we're on the circle, we're going to stay on it and we're going to focus on what their body's doing. So I want you to feel which way their body's wanting to go and react accordingly. So if they're trying to pull in, more inside, out, more outside. Good, right, come on. Good. Relax, lengthen that right brain a little bit. That's a little bit more outside leg there, Sarah, so it doesn't drift onto that fence. Good. Look up, look where you're going. Good. Keep your hands still. That's it. Still longer outside rein, Olivia. Okay, now start to gradually decrease the circle. So you're starting to bring, stay inside the dressage arena. By leg heeling in. I don't want to see any backwards contact at all. Everything that you do, I want you to think right forward to the hand. Allow the outside hand there to lift. Good. Allow more with the outside hand. Very good. Outside leg, Sarah, good. And don't let it push you to the outside. Right, nose more than that leg. Good. Just keep giving and taking down that inside rein so you're making them carry themselves. That's it. Don't give them anything to lean against. More forwards, Olivia. That's it. See how it dropped into that then, Sarah. That was very good. There. Stay for yours, Olivia. Don't try pulling down. Skip and stay. Come on. It's on her, sorry. There. More inside leg there, Sarah. Don't go to load that inside shoulder. Good. Okay, and then gradually we're going to lay heels out. We're going to ask them to start to step across with the hind leg, but you're still turning the shoulders. Allow with the outside hand, Olivia. Good. Rise the body. Soft arms. Very good. Well done. Very good. Don't press that inside hand down, Olivia. Keep it up. Keep it up. Come more forward. Come bigger step. And now go large from there, Sarah. And ride forward. And go larger again. And ride more forward. There. Don't get frequency. Keep shoulders tall. Shoulders above your hips. You're not riding over your hands. Well done. What does that feel like, Olivia?
Yeah, much better.
Much better, quicker this week.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't get backwards in that hand. Okay, now slow your rise to walk. Well done. And then check your girth and change your rein. Bigger steps. More forwards there. Olivia, good. And again, stay off the track, so you're halfway between the two. That's good. It's a little bit stiffer this way, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you've got to ride in more with your left, right leg into your left hand. Don't block with that left hand. Good. And then when you're ready, change your head. Go on to a circle and get action to the gate head instead.
That's very good.
Don't press the hand down.
Yep.
Keep the hand up. At the gate end, Sarah, please. Good. Come right forward. Well done. Hands still. And that's it there. Super. That's a better drop there, Sarah. That's a much longer stride as well, Olivia. Well done. Do you feel better?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. And go with that. That's right. Don't block her through the hand. Now when you ask to come onto this circle, keep your inside hand up, Sarah, but keep your quite strong. You hate it, that means cancer? Well, let's say diagonals to stick onto the wrong one. Good. And no downward pressure at all. Shoulders back up. Good, 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 good. Good. There, that. Bend yourself on the chest. Very good. Keep pushing that ribcage out. Don't let that shoulder drop in. Every chance you can, lift it towards your inside leg a little bit more and ride the body. Go more inside leg. More inside leg. Very good. Very good. Good. Go out the outside leg. That's it now. Just keep the inside leg on as you start to decrease the circle, so that you're giving them something to work around. Good. Good. Look where you're going. Allow the outside hand. Good. Excellent. Well done. Okay, now what I want you to do, once you're in the arena, don't worry, there's no rush for you. That's good. Now watch, ask for a little bit more bend, Sarah, and then give with the inside hand. That's a good shot, bottom. You ask for the bend and then release, so there's no pressure. It's just guiding in the direction in the way you want them to go. Give a little feel and an upwards feel down that right leg. Super easy there. Yep. You find it hard, you can get that snatch. Sarah, go for it. Don't block with the outside hand when that happens.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's it, Sarah, there. Good. It's guiding you, giving you the direction where you want them to go, and then when you've done it, reward you by giving. So it's that seek and reward. Yeah, so, yeah. That's it. That's when you're going to be quicker to react with that leg. Allow the breath to get outside hand. And when he loses it, his head comes back to say, oh, I can't do it. Very good. Very good, both of you. Because actually, interestingly, they're both a little bit stiffer this way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just watch this way, Olivia. She's not pushing you to the inside. Okay, and then quietly start to leg heels out. Good. Ride the body out. And just go up that way. Okay, now go back. Make sure you're quite well spaced out. And what I want you to do is now put your legs into a certain set. Yeah? So we can put right focus on riding the body, not the head.
What did you say, sorry, Pam?
Ride a circle any way you want.
Okay.
Much great, Sarah. Well done. And once you're organized,
and the ears come back and she can't come.
Yeah, and that's when she gets irritable and that, you know, nasty with you.
Yeah.
But she look now, she's in much more trouble.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, very good. But it's got a good stretch and walk. So he is just a star, isn't he? Inside leg, push it into that outside hand. Very good. Very good, well done. Okay, when you're ready, guys, go forward to planter. And be brave with your yak. Yeah?
Yeah.
Easier this way, sir. Easier to have this way. Well done, brilliant. Oh, Sarah, sorry, this is drilling.
Yep.
I've just pulled up at the house. Not only have I just seen a little like foreign lady from Just Eat on a motorbike, and she's just fell on the floor coming around the corner, and all the other cars just sat there and just looked at her. So I got out for that to help her, and then I've just been literally just reversed up our drive, and while I'm sitting here getting the camera out, my car, even though it's off, has just rolled down the drive. So I don't know where my car's going to be when I come out in the morning. Anywho, lesson was fab. Ended up just me and one other girl, so Pam could really, really see every little detail that was happening. The canter was a bit sticky for the transition, but once she was going, wow, has she got such a big canter, I couldn't even sit to it. And she loaded both there and back within minutes, which is also such a bonus. I'm rolling again. My car's not going to be on the drive when I come back. The weather's horrendous. It took us ages to get back because it was snowing when we came out the lesson as well. So I'm going to wrap that up there and figure out how I'm going to keep my car on the drive. And thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed another flat work lesson. There's not going to be one next week, even though I am going, because Phoebe's going to bring her actual camera and take some pictures instead of vlogging. But don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment on this video. Bye, guys.